Welcome to module 5 video, which is part 5. In the last video we discussed about local replication technologies, and the first one we discussed, it is a host based technique, and next is the storage array based local replication. So here the array operating environment performs the local replication process, and the CPU, memory, etc. are not used in the replication. So in this figure you can find you have a production host which is attached to the source, and the replica of this source all within the same storage array. Okay, and replica is the one which is accessed by other hosts. Okay, so the source's replica is created, which is made available to the other host, PC host, business continuity host. Okay, so this works in three ways, that is full volume mirroring, pointer based full volume replication, pointer based virtual replication. So you can see the three differences. Okay, and they are based on four aspects. Okay, just go through them. We will be discussing each one now. First is the full volume mirroring. Okay, full volume mirroring technique says that it is quite simple. The idea is the target is attached to the source and is a mirror of the source. Okay, so you have attached and detached mode here. So when the source is writing or copying to the target, in that attached state the BC host cannot access the target. Okay, when the target is attached to the source, it remains unavailable to any other host. However, the production host continues to access the source. When the synchronization is complete, the target is detached from the source and made available for other BC operations. Okay, when this detached mode, you can see a detachment here, and within the same storage array the target is made available to the BC host. Next is pointer based full volume replication. Here unlike the first one, the target is immediately accessible after the replication session is activated, and there is no detachment. Okay, now it activates in two modes, that is copy on first access, COFA mode, and full copy mode. So in the first one, full copy mode, okay, you have just this, that all the data from the source is copied to the target. Okay, and this makes the target a viable copy for the restore and other business operations. Now the next is copy on first access, and we'll be discussing write to source, write to target, and read from target under that heading, copy on first access. So you have the production host, and supposing when a write is issued to the source for the first time after a replication session activation, so write to the source, now this is the source having ABC. Now the production host gives a command to write C dash. So in that case, original data at that address is copied to the target first of all. So C is copied to the target. Okay, then the new data is updated on the source, and the C here in the source becomes C dash. This ensures that the original data at the point of activation is preserved on the target. As you can see, target has C. Then next is write to targets, that is given by to target writing, that command is given by the BC host. Okay, in this case, when a write is issued to the target for the first time, the original data is copied from the source to the target. So from the source, B is copied here first of all, then the new data will be updated to B dash. Okay, write to target, B dash is given, and that B will be updated to B dash. Next is read from target. In that case, ABC were already there in the target. Okay, and when a read is issued to the target for the first time, the original data is copied from the source to the target, that is ABC, and is made available to the BC host. Okay, so now read request for A, and that is made available to the BC host. Next is pointer based virtual replication. So the difference here is that the target contains pointers to the location of the data to the source. The target does not hold any data at any time. Okay, that is why it is a virtual replica, but hold pointers where the data is stored. Okay, Then here also the target is immediately accessible after the replication session activation. It uses COFW, that was COFA, this is COFW technology. Okay, so here let's consider write to source and write to target. Okay, so write to source, now it is, the figure goes like this. You have the source, okay, ABC, and write to source as C dash. So the target virtual device is given here, and in that relay the location is saved, location of C will be saved. Okay, when a write is issued to the source for the first time, original data at that address is copied to the save location, okay, save location, which is in the target virtual device. Okay, the pointer in the target is updated to the point to this data in the save location, and the new write is updated on the source. So you can see, and after that C is in the save location, then C will be converted to C dash. Then here write to target, so that is given by the BC host, so it comes to the target virtual device, this write request. Okay, so here also the original data from the source device is copied to the save location, okay, and then the pointer is updated to the data in the save location. So A was there and it changes to A dash, okay, because of the write request. Okay, another copy of the original data is created in the save location before the new write is updated. Okay, so that is all about the second part, that is storage array based local replication. Next is network based. The third type is network based local replication, and it combines the benefits of the first one, host based, and second one, array based techniques. It is ideal for highly heterogeneous environments. It uses a technology called continuous data protection, CDP. Okay, so it provides the ability to restore data to any previous point in time. Okay, that is the ability of continuous data protection. And recovery point objectives, that is the time to recover. Okay, and they are random and does not need to be defined in advance. So some features. Okay, now CDP is implemented using journal volume, CDP appliance, write splitters, and host base. So journal volume is nothing but CDP journal. It is used to store all data changes on the primary storage. CDP appliance is an intelligent hardware platform that runs CDP software. Write splitters, again it is to do the writing, then, and it splits each writes into two copies. Okay, then host base means it is again a software installed on the separate host machine. So this replication operation is just this, the figure is given. Okay, before you start the replication, the replica is synchronized with the source, and then so you have the host. Okay, after the replication starts, all the writes to the source are split into two copies, and one of the copies is sent to the CDP appliance. So from the host, one copy is sent to the CDP appliance. Okay, it is written to the journal volume. This arrow here shows that it is written to the journal volume. Then next step, it is it makes a replica at regular intervals. Okay, so while recovering data to the source, CDP appliance restores the data from the replica and applies journal entries up to the PIT, which is chosen for recovery. So it is very clear from the figure. Now, local replication in virtual environment. Okay, how does it happen in a virtual environment? So in this case, it is performed by a virtual machine, a hypervisor. Okay, and two options, that is VM snapshot and the VM clone. Basically, this is the figure. In a virtualized environment, how replication is done is, the virtualization appliance at the SAN abstracts, loons, and creates virtual volumes. Okay, so you have loons in the storage array which have mirror legs. Okay, and these are available as virtual volume. Okay, so the virtual appliance, you can see it here, virtual appliance, okay, abstracts the loons and creates virtual volumes, and they are given to the virtual volumes are given to the host, you can see, and host will apply the IOs. Okay, the figure shows the illustration of the virtual volume mirrored between arrays within the data center. So this is the data center, and each IO to the virtual volume is mirrored to the underlying loons on the array. So it is a virtual environment. So whatever IO that is given from the host to the virtual volume will be mirrored to your loons. Okay, and it's again mirror legs are there. Okay, so just go through it. Then we have the VM snapshot as one implementation and VM clone as another implementation for the virtualized replication of local data. Okay, so VM snapshot captures the state and data of the running virtual machine at a specific PIT. It involves VM files, BIOS, etc. All these are covered in the snapshot. VM snapshot uses a separate delta file to record all the changes. So these are the features when using VM snapshot. Challenges is that it does not support data replication if VM accesses data using raw disk. Okay, then using hypervisor will increase the load on the compute performance. Then VM clone is a method that creates identical copy of the virtual machine again. So cloning operation is the thing here. Okay, it the clone becomes a separate VM from its parent, having its own MAC address, and changes made to the clone again further does not affect the parent VM. Okay, so clone is again a replica. Okay, and vice versa, the changes on the parent does not appear in the clone. Okay, so that is about our local replica technologies. Okay, we discussed in three stages, that is host based, storage, array based, and network based, and the virtual environment also. So next is explain restore and restart considerations. Just point that the local replicas are used for restoring. Okay, so what are the considerations? Now for example, the source has a failure, maybe an accidental deletion of data, etc. In that case, a solution one, what are the considerations my look out here. So consideration one or solution one is restore the data from the source, from the target to the source. Okay, the second consideration is the data applications must be resumed on the production devices. Okay, another consideration is so as the production device might be unavailable, the application must be restarted on the latest replica. Another consideration is to create a gold copy, that is another copy of the an additional copy of the replica device. Okay, that is a gold copy. So to create a gold copy would be another consideration. Okay, so resolve the issues with the source, continuing the operations. Okay, so I'm concluding my video here. Next topic, remote replication.